but it's weird because there's some dudes out there. Not that that's weird, it's just, I mean, I'd rather look at a naked girl. Actually, I should take all that back. My mom decided that she was going to become a huge fan of the band, and which is a big thing for me because I was a middle child growing up, and it took me a lot to be part of the family, and I think now that they're actually proud of me for, you know, being... Oh, thank you. Proud of me for being in a band. She started watching all of our YouTube videos that you guys were filming and posting online. She called me kind of midway through the tour, and she's like, "Travi, you need to be way more appropriate on stage, or else I'm gonna slap you in the face when you get home." So I decided that I would change my approach, and instead of saying stuff like, well, actually I already said it this morning, so, or this evening, so I kind of already messed it up, but instead of saying songs are about sexual intercourse, I have a whole new plan, and I need you guys to be with me on this one because of me being appropriate. But does everybody here know about the birds and the bees, more or less? Cool. Alright, well, if you don't know, I'm going to teach it to you right now, because my dad, when he tried to teach me growing up, it was very difficult. For 15 minutes, I had this terrifying image of this really nice bird being stabbed to death by a bee, and like a humping motion, too. It was very awkward, not making sounds. And then out of nowhere, like 9 months later, out pops a human baby, and even when I was young, I wasn't that dumb. I knew that human babies didn't come from, you know, birds and bees. They came from storks that were left on your front porch. And so as I grew up and kind of learned what this was all about, I figured out an easier way to explain it. So bear with me. You have your bird, and it's a really pretty bird. It probably uses some sort of herbal essences or fancy probies. Where are you? So you have your bird who smells real nice, and then you have your bee, and it's got really straight and even lines and strong wings and stuff, and for the longest time I couldn't figure out which one was the male, but then it became so evident to me and so clear that obviously it was the bee was the male because he has the stinger. And just a fun little fact for everybody to know, he doesn't get bummed out when he sees another bee flapping by that has a slightly larger stinger, because he knows in his little bee brain that it's all about the motion and the ocean. That, ladies and gentlemen, is as appropriate as I can possibly think of getting. Maybe if we're all really quiet, we can all hear this. Scooter. Hey, we have a guy named Scooter in our band, he's pretty much our professional babysitter. And it's his job to make sure I get guitars on stage that work. And so, right now he's failing, and I'll take a poll whether we should fire him or not.
No!
We can't afford to lose him anyway, so I'm really happy that you guys don't make him fire. We just came to a conclusion that you're not fired. In case you're this next song I'm going to play, once everything's back up and running, is a really special song to me, because I think it's hands down the most romantic song I've ever written in my entire life. And hopefully one day I'll find a girl that I can actually sing it to. We're just all going to pretend that this is an acoustic guitar.
Okay.
This next song is, as I said, the most romantic song I've ever written. And maybe that girl that I'm looking for is in Arizona right now. The song is called You and Only You.
Every single day I wait, I just can't wait to see your face.